Place called Chidambaram. Chidambaram. Lord Shiva's famous temple is there. Is there. And Chidambaram means Chit. And then Ambar. Ambar means space, sky. And Chit means it's something related to the consciousness. And many people, there is a saying in South India especially, Chidambar Rahasya. Rahasyam, they say. Rahasya means secret. The secret of Chidambaram. This is what it is. The mantan. And how it happens, who will manage, how to manage, how they are done. All these things is totally rahasyam. Secret. It was not even revealed to Saptarishis. Saptarishis, you know, they are the first gurus of the cosmos. They are the first gurus of the cosmos. They are not only gurus, they are the fathers, forefathers of the whole cosmic family. These rishis, these guys always sat. You know, there is one avatara of Lord Shiva called Dakshinamurti. He sits under the tree. Facing south, towards the south, he will sit like this in Chin Mudra. And then around him, all these Saptarishis sit. They did chakra piercing and all the Jnana Yoga, Bhakti Yoga for thousands and thousands, millions of years they would do this. They are still doing. They are still, their souls are still remaining in this only. But yet, they come to him. Look, we are not able to understand your tattva. Who you are, what you do and all. We are still not able to understand. Tell us. You know what Dakshinamurti will say? Don't talk. Just sit around. Don't ask anything. Just sit around. You will know everything from inside. No, we have some questions, they say. If you ask a question called A, and I will explain. Then again B will come. You will again have another question called B. I will explain. Then again you will have another question called C. Then again, there is no end for your questions. So knowing will not happen by asking questions. So, don't talk. Sit around. You will know everything from inside. If you don't have faith, don't sit here. You will never know. Go to Google. He also said, go to Google and know the information. That is only information. That is not knowing or knowledge. That is only information. Information is like big stone on your head. You keep carrying lot of baggage. So many stones on your head. The more stones you carry, the more behind you fall. You will not advance because that's all like weight that you are carrying. So, that is what is this Chidambar Rahasyam. This Chidambar Rahasyam of Samudra Manthan will never be known to the humans. The total operation remains only in the cosmic management team. And when it will happen, you know, the CEO of the cosmos, all the top three guys, they will only initiate it. And above them, there is another supreme source. That supreme source with that command, that will never take the body also, that will not come down. That source, because of that source guidance only, these three guys operate. And they have to, it's a phenomenon. After so many millions of years only that phenomenon happens. Because the nature totally falls behind. Just the way I explained, the whole prosperity and all those things have gone to the negative energies. Because of which, even now in Kali Yuga, what is happening? Now what is, why this is initiated? The churning that is initiated by following the path of Ohmism that will start in you. Why this is started? It started again because the whole prosperity, the peace, plus the knowledge, the light, all, everything is gone to the negative energies.
the Kundalini, it's involved, this Samudra Manthan is known to negative people.
There are negative spiritual practitioners on the earth.
They know more about this.
Positive people have left totally.
So the knowledge is gone to totally the
negative people, and they are implementing it negatively, totally in the world.
That's the reason why money, peace, prosperity, everything is gone to now negative energies. It's remaining with negative people.
And they are the ones who are ruling the cosmos.
And the nature has fallen behind from its advancement. And good people, people like you, you are considerably good people. But the problem with you is your mind. You will never accept that there is a knowledge like this and something could happen. You will always think that nothing will happen out of, there is no science like this, you will think. That's your belief. That's the reason why you people have remained energyless. You people don't have peace, you people don't have knowledge, you people don't have light, you people go to offices, suffer. You may have little money and all good money, but still there is no peace. Because of these only. So you need to start believing it and start adopting the technology. Basically, it's like a knife. Knife is gone to now negative people. Because you are scared of knife. Why should you be scared of knife? You should know how to use a knife. Then the knife will remain with you. But by just because I am talking about all these things, you are scared of knife and you will leave the knife. The knife is gone to the negative people. They are using it. So the total energy. Today, spiritual people, people like you, some people even good at spirituality, they are not able to face the negative energies. So many people around are fighting with them. So many people around them are blaming them. They are throwing stones on them. They are totally putting them down. There was recently some suicide happened in Bollywood, some actor. So that's also in this case only. So good people are not able to face the world because of this. You should also have the knife. Then you will be able to stand firmly. But because you people are thinking, especially what is, I say, anger. You people carry some kind of belief that anger is very, very bad. Spiritual people should not have anger. They should totally kill their anger. Means if somebody throws stones on you, then accept them, get beaten up, is what you are saying. That's fine. If you are unmarried and if you don't have any job, if you don't have any family and no commitments, you know, you have left the whole family, you are sitting under the tree and you can wear underwear and you can eat a little fruits. And then you are required to be totally dropping of the anger. That's meant for such people. But if you are going to office and then you have family, you face the world, you face so many people and you face bad people and all, then in order to sustain in life and in order to take care of your family and all these, the anger has to be at a required level. That is why this path is meant for married people. And when this churning happens, the manthan happens in you, you become like a black hole. Or you become like an energy sucker. You become some kind of pool, and that pool, you know, is managing the stability of cosmos. You become like that. So you not only transform yourself, you also transform yourself, but you also add value to the whole nature in such a way that, you know, I told you already that the money, prosperity, you know, authority, power, everything is gone to the negative energies. So now the manthan is started to bring back, to balance and then bring back all these things to the positive energies.
you will start seeing. Corona itself actually came. It's actually not some kind of negative thing. It's come. It's part of this ocean churning, the churning of the nature. It's come to bring back the power and also the money and all to the positive side. This is one of those events. Corona is one of those events. You will see in about 3-4 months or in the next 1 year, you will see lot of shifting happening, like, you know, the money in the world will start shifting to the positive people. So like that, what happens is that's because I do not want to say too much about it. So if you do this kriya, you know, the mantan kriya, if it happens, so many such balancing activities happen naturally. It's not that you do, again, don't misunderstand it, but the mantan actually balances so many things in the world. Anger needs to be there, but it has to be there at a required level. In the graph XY you have, and then for a required level it has to be there, then only you can manage your lives. So it's like that. So Chidambaram is one thing. Chidambaram Rahasya will never be revealed to the ordinary people. So that knife is nothing. You will get the knife here. It's atomism. No, that doesn't mean that I am a murderer. Again, don't campaign like that. No, what I mean to say is, the meaning of knife is, you will have required energy that will let you face the world. That is what it means. Don't literally take it. So that's how it is. You will get all the required energies to face the world. And knowing the complete secret of Chidambaram will not happen. That can never come to you. It did not happen to even Saptarishis. So you get the energies, you be happy with it, you evolve, and then you get self-realized. All those things will happen. But the Chidambaram Rahasyam will not be revealed. It was not even revealed to the Saptarishis. Basically, this is the play of divine forces. This is the play of divine forces. Meaning, the technology, that cosmic management system. You know, what do they do? This entire corporation is cosmos is one incorporation for them. And the managers, directors of that cosmic management system, they have divine energies. They have controlling powers to control the cosmos, to control the nature. That controlling power will never be given to an ordinary human. But the technology, the divine technology, is brought down for the faster evolution of human race because it has fallen behind. So the technology comes down, use it, evolve. But what is this technology? How to do all those things? How to control the nature and all? No. That will never come to an ordinary human. It will never. Ravana was a great spiritualist. Even he did not have. Vishwamitra, some 5000 years he did. He became Brahmarshi. Even he did not have. Saptarishis, the source of the cosmos, even they don't have. So, the actual thing will not be revealed. So you evolve. It's meant for evolution. You know, those days Ravana wanted to steal this technology. That's why he actually kidnapped Sita. Those days Sita was actually Prakruti. So he kidnapped her and he wanted to control the nature. So he wanted to take the nature into his hands and all. So he got killed. So this technology would never get into the hands of even great gurus, Anandas, Acharyas, or gurus, Sadgurus, or so many gurus, you know, Swamis, all of them were only saints. They could never get access to this. I told you about Vishwamitra, right? So
Sattarishis also did not get access. So all those spiritual saints would not get access. Only Krishna had the access. Krishna. And after Krishna, again, only now the new software has come called Kalki. Only that has the access to this. And nobody else would have the access to it. Some people came to, and then they, you know, practiced the path for a few years and all, but they never were trying to reveal their actual, you know, what they were, their intentions. They never revealed their intentions. But here, nobody can fool around or cheat the guru here. Because all cameras, 360 degrees, they keep watching you. So, they wanted to stay, you know, they wanted to get the energy and do many more things on their own. You know what happens? In the whole churning, so many things come out. I'll tell you, probably in the next video you can experience. You will get Lakshmi, the prosperity, out of the churning. These are all the outcomes. You may get Kalpavriksha and all those things. At the end, they will get, you know, some Amrit will come. So they wanted to get probably Lakshmi and Alakshmi also comes. So they wanted to get Lakshmi and Amrit and all they wanted to get, but nature doesn't somehow allow them to be with me. They would leave halfway. So that's how it happens here. This kriya is totally divine secret. Chidambara Rahasyam. It will never be revealed. You know, the Shiva in Chidambaram temple, you know, the Nataraj, he stands like this. And then he's standing, the way he stands itself is the symbol of the Kundalini, the perfect movement of snake. Okay? And then the snake would be there in his, around his chest or probably stomach and all, this area, you know, and it would be swirl like this and it would have a tail like this. It's the sign of Manthan, the churning, and he would have the leg like this, showing his foot. You hold my foot. This is the only way for you. Surrender to this, and this is the only way, grace. And the hand that shows Abhayahasta is the grace. And one leg stands like this, showing his foot. Another hand shows his foot. And this is some explanation about it. So this is the cosmic secret that is happening for creation, sustenance and destruction with all the cosmic forces. That's the secret, the Chidambara Rahasyam. And how it happens, all these things is Chidambara Rahasya. That is why Chidambaram temple has got deeper meaning in it. The Chidambara Rahasyam does not just mean the explanation of Nataraja and the way he stands and all. That is not the Rahasya. The deepest Rahasya is there. That is this, the churning, the Mantan. And that will never be known. That's totally secretive. It's totally in the hands of the supernatural power only. And to control the nature. And then to run this for creation, sustenance and destruction. Not even the divine souls, the devatas, nobody. They would also not have. Even Kali, Mahakali, all those, they also would not have this power. So this is, the Manthan is totally secretive. It's totally divine. It's totally a divine operation that will never be revealed to any of these Babas, Swamis, Acharyas, Anandas and all. Huh? And it will only happen, and this Manthan Kriya only happens when the creation gets into totally imbalanced state. That's when the Avatara comes down. After Krishna, Kalki comes down and he is working by soul. And because of that, this Manthan is again reinitiated in the churning is reinitiated in the cosmos to bring balance in the nature and also to bring the prosperity, peace and all to the positive energies. That's why this is Chidambara Rahasyam. The Manthan Kriya is Chidambara Rahasyam.
नटराज नाट्य विराजा।